The invitation by Cooper Surgical is appreciated to present to you today on our experiences dealing with gametes, embryos and tissues from seropositive patients. I was retained by Cooper Surgical for the purpose of this lecture and I declare no conflict of interest with regards to the content of the report. This webinar will discuss key aspects of risk minimization and preventative actions in an art laboratory when managing samples from seropositive patients. That is to refer to the effective laboratory procedures for the treatment of HIV-positive patients that can be used as a blueprint in the current COVID-19 pandemic. Key elements for this talk will be, to start with, setting the stage on the environment we operate in, then to touch on the consequences of viral infections on fertility, thereafter to look at elements that will impact on infections in an ART program, such as staff and patients, facilities and supplies, as well as ART procedures, then to summarize. Since the beginning of the millennium, the HIV-acquired immune deficiency syndrome, AIDS, epidemic was at the center of our attention globally and especially in sub-Saharan Africa. Therefore, the focus for us in the ART lab is always on infectious diseases and patient-related sicknesses. It is also true that the social evenness in a region or society will determine the accessibility to technological excellence. However, it is the preparedness and application of the knowledge at hand that will impact on the outcome of a situation. In order to illustrate the variability of diseases that we deal with, the following beautiful illustration by Krasinski and co-workers. This visualizes the genomes of different bacteria and viruses, where the x-axis represents the worldwide annual cases and the y-axis illustrates mortality, that is, disease burden and cases resulting in death. The yellow circles highlight some of the diseases, such as HIV, malaria, and TB, which are prevalent in Southern Africa, with the position of COVID-19 indicated in green dotted lines. The effectiveness and thus upward positioning of COVID-19 on the graph relates to the virus being an airborne associated disease, while HIV is bloodborne. Therefore, what are the consequences of viral infections on fertility? Viral particles can be transmitted by a range of routes and can cause direct viral damage or immune-mediated damage, while vertical transmission can result in genome integration or embryonic abnormalities, whereas horizontal transmission can occur between partners or patients, health workers, and ART samples. This slide will be used as the backbone of this presentation in order to illustrate the procedures that we have implemented when dealing with possible infections. This will include bloodborne viruses and reinforcement of preventative measures for possible airborne transmissions. The slide segments the ART program. Patients, lab or clinical staff are positioned in the middle of the graph, with bodily fluids indicated as blood and semen. This is shown with horizontal stripes, and the environment and supplies are spatially positioned next to the laboratory and clinic. The protocols and practices referred to during the discussion are described in a human reproduction monograph in 2008 and Facts, Views and Visions article in 2014, and in the current South African COVID-19 ART guidelines on the treatment of patients, as well as well-known practical reference literature such as clean room technology in ART clinics. Let us then start with the diagnostic phase, which includes the prevention of lateral transmission. Staff rotations and shifts are staggered with time-specific telephonic or online communications to streamline interactions and reduce waiting time. With regards to patients, currently only time-sensitive patients are earmarked for treatments. Also, home semen collections are encouraged and preferred in many cases, with the partner bringing the sample to the laboratory within an hour. Correct PPE use is encouraged, as well as the use of face shields and masks are promoted. Cloth masks are currently mandatory in public spaces in South Africa. The workload will also be adapted in advance according to the number of experienced staff available. Also, to accommodate at least 5 complete air changes between ART procedures, which is approximately 15 to 20 minutes. Buffer zones are created for different purposes in the laboratory. The next segment refers to facilities or laboratory environment and the supplies. The IVF clean room is viewed as the safest section of our unit, that is, low levels of environmental pollutants and strict access control. We direct samples according to the serostatus of patients with dedicated seropositive and seronegative clean rooms. Seroconcordant patients are handled as if both partners are seropositive. Patients are then batched according to the serostatus with samples from seropositive patients the last to enter the clean room. In addition to the daily clean room quality control checks, the following items have been included. Deliveries are received in the buffer zone of the lab, the outer packaging removed in this area, and the items wiped with ART-Safe disinfectant. Tracing of items from the outside to the inside of the clean room and the number of embryologists in the area will be strictly controlled. Also, daily replacement of all white sticky mats at the outside of all clean room areas will be monitored. We have purchased additional ART-Safe disinfectant wipes, and an extra coda area system is considered in order to remove possible pollutants that are generated with the best of intentions. It is important to also take note that references have been made to the potential toxicity of disinfectants, and care should be taken to prevent the buildup of compounds and to standardize the cleaning protocols. The next segment refers to the laboratory procedures, and we will begin with the spermatology section. Detailed history taking is especially important in the current times. It is well known that sperm DNA integrity of fertile males can be negatively impacted after a few days of fever. Thus, drastic changes in sperm parameters compared to previous spermiograms should be probed and further investigated. As per protocol, all semen samples are handled as if from seropositive patients, processed in a class 2 biosafety cabinet, aerosol formation is avoided, and closed centrifugation buckets are used. Following an appropriate semen decontamination method is optional. The figure illustrates the Pro Insert and Repro Star. Both these devices were designed with safety in mind and to use with density gradient centrifugation. The devices are designed to access the purified sperm fraction without contamination to the upper density gradient layers. Pandemics have emerged periodically through the ages, with HIV, avian, and swine flu, as well as SARS coronavirus recently. There is currently no direct evidence of the SARS-CoV-2 transmission or flu viruses via the human reproductive tract. It is, however, important to keep an eye out for brand new publications on the subject, which refers to testicular damage and the possibility for sexual transmissions. We have done extensive research with the Pro Insert, with some of the publications indicated. Semen was originally spiked with live cultures of HIV, HCV and other viruses, and fractions were PCR tested. Further experimentation indicated that using the decontamination methodology, HIV-1 RNA was removed from all samples, and DNA was eradicated from 98% of the semen of seropositive males. This method is standardized in our laboratory and used as the golden standard in this time. Then to move on to the embryology section. Similar to the handling of samples for seropositive patients, the appropriate PPE techniques will be used with double gloves to facilitate the quick and safe removal of a soiled glove. This is also applicable to the handling of semen samples. Manipulation with bare hands are permitted when handling embryos. Time-lapse cultures and evaluations are always preferred above static evaluations, one reason being to minimize travel and walkabouts. Similar to the culture protocols for samples for seropositive patients, are the frequency of washing droplets for oocyte and embryos increased. Additional ART-safe disinfectant wipes are used between cases and patient samples, and standard laboratory protocols for insemination of oocytes and culture are followed, that is, for IVF, ICSI, and IUI. We only use closed cryopreservation carriers and dedicated liquid nitrogen DWARS during cryopreservation of seropositive and negative samples. A separate DWAR is allocated for patients in the current COVID-19 time period. The disease burden of a region or country will definitely impact on preventative actions, and it will be a juncture between preventative actions and risk minimization in the ART lab. The consequences of viral infections on human fertility will depend on the viral characteristics and population susceptibility. Each laboratory should perform an in-depth analysis of all their in-house practices and elements which impact on infections in their ART program. Examples of procedure adaptations were discussed during the present talk. Then to summarize, I would like to acknowledge all team contributions to the gathering of knowledge on the ART lab treatment of seropositive patients.